One skill which we use almost always in our lives is that of negotiation. Whether it is while we are purchasing vegetables from the market, having discussions around our salary with an organization, contract discussions with a client, or even if as a business leader, it is the discussion around some merger, acquisition, or maybe some new contracts. But are we always successful in the negotiations that we are doing? The answer is no. Every negotiation is not successful. And a couple of main reasons for this are, firstly, the preparation level, and secondly, the approach of both the parties who are involved in that negotiation process. In this video, I am sharing 6 such rules which will help you in being successful in your business negotiations as well as in your personal lives. If you want to learn these rules well and implement these in your life, then you must watch this video till the very end and start using these to assure success for yourself. If you want to learn these rules well and implement these in your life, then you must watch this video till the very end and start using these to assure success for yourself. Before we proceed, don't forget to press the subscribe button and of course turn on all the notifications as well. When you do this, you will keep on constantly getting many information about the videos, learning videos which I keep releasing on this channel, as well as some stories which will help you learn. At the start, you must decide whether in a discussion, sale or a contract, is negotiation really required? It is often seen that the salespeople say that the customers want us to negotiate. But shouldn't it be your decision? When you're finalizing a contract and till the time there is no conflict arising, should you negotiate really? You must ideally only negotiate when it becomes absolutely important in order to have a win-win approach towards this negotiation and the closure. Always remember, conflict gives birth to negotiations. There is another video around managing the conflicts which I have on this channel for you, which you can watch by clicking on this link here. A real life example of a negotiation can be, suppose that you're working in a store, in a shopping mall, and a customer comes to you with a product for some discount that he or she wants. You tell that customer that, I'm sorry, but the prices are fixed and there is no possibility of any discount in this. So actually what you've done is you decided in your mind that this discount is non-negotiable. Though you might even have had the option to provide a discount of maybe up to 4-5%. But this was your decision. So stick to it until it becomes a challenge in closing this sale. The second rule to have a positive impact on negotiation is to prepare well. You are required to list down all your options for negotiation at one place. Then you need to take every option one by one and evaluate the interests and the position of the other person or the party with whom you are negotiating, and then compare these with respect to your own interests and position. When you prepare for a negotiation, using this technique, then it will help you in being ready and being prepared once you reach the negotiation table. For example, your company supplies goods to another company, right? Now, that company has asked you to come for a parts supply contract negotiation discussion. Now, what can be a few questions which you need to prepare? Of course, you need to do the preparation for this discussion. So, the first question, your product rates in comparison to the competitor product rates, where do they stand? Second, the difference in the quality of the products, your products versus the competition products, where do you stand? Then the third one is the comparison of your delivery time with respect to your competitor's delivery time. Which one is better? Fourth, The difference between the after-sales service which you provide versus what your competitor is providing. Fifth, if you are to offer a discount, then what can be the maximum limit of this discount which you can offer? These are a few important questions which you can actually make use of while you are preparing for your negotiation. The third rule for negotiation is that you must not start negotiating with yourself in your mind till the time you have all the required information or the details. You have gone for a business deal and you had planned that this deal will ideally be closing somewhere around 30 lakhs or maybe 3 million rupees. When you reach the office of the client, then you see that there is a person sitting beneath a broken fan in front of a dirty table and he's in a shabby looking shirt. Remember, however much preparation you do, some things will come to light only after the negotiation discussions begin, or maybe once the negotiation process starts off. You ask that person and you find out that he only is your client. Now, instead of thinking that would the owner of such an office, will be he able to close the deal of 30 lakhs? You must try to first ascertain more details about him. Now you ask that person and you find out that he only is your client. Now, instead of thinking that whether the owner of such an office be able to close this deal of 30 lakhs, you must first try to ascertain more details about him while you are discussing this deal. When you are discussing this deal, you must speak and that should be around your initial offer of 30 lakhs which you had thought of. In case if this amount is beyond the budget of that individual, he or she will share it. There might even be a possibility that he is able to close this deal and he shares with you that this office is just a temporary makeshift arrangement that he has done and he is planning to shift to his new office maybe in a few days from now. Or maybe that he does not like to spend on these things till he cracks a bigger deal. Maybe he is just waiting for that moment. Fourth and a very important rule of negotiation is, do not accept the first offer. If we consider the previous example itself, you were planning to close this deal in 30 lakhs, right? The person who is sitting in front of you, he says, I think it is 20 lakhs. Ideally, you should be asking a few more questions. For example, maybe I had sent you a mail where I had shared the complete breakup of this 30 lakh amount. I'm sure you must have seen that mail and have gone through the details. Now, after listening to this, even your client won't say, oh yes, 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 I've gone through your mail. I think, yeah, wow, wonderful. I think let us just close this. That's not the way it happens. To clarify further, you will need to ask more questions and explain the contract points to your client and then impress upon him or her why this amount of 30 lakhs is justified. You must always keep this in your mind. Just like you would not accept the first amount that is offered by the other person, even he or she will not accept it in the first take itself. The fifth rule of negotiation is to speak less and listen more. A question which can be quite helpful in this regard, that can be, what do you feel about this offer? You must be careful while choosing the words that you speak. You should not be asking, so how do you like this offer? You might even get a response that, well, I think your offer seems to be a bit too high. Therefore, listen and question well, so that you are able to understand what are the feelings about that person, the other person or the other party. This will help you understand more before you give any reaction. There is another video where I have explained about effective listening. In case if you want to learn about that, you can always click on this link to view the same. The sixth rule when you're getting into a negotiation is to decide upon the end result. And this should be ideally done before you start off. That when this negotiating party is, when we are coming to a conclusion, it should ideally be win-win or a no deal. Win-win means that the negotiating parties get a result which is acceptable to both. And a no deal means, in case that we are unable to mutually find out a mutually acceptable solution, we will jointly take a call to actually call off this deal, maybe some other time in the future. In case if there is only one party which is getting benefited by the end result of this negotiation, then of course the other party or the person will always carry a grudge against it, which is not the way it should be. So in case if both the parties have decided that when we reach the end, it would be either a win-win or a no deal, then of course you will feel quite liberated while you are involved in that negotiation process. This also affects your energy as well as your involvement in the negotiation process. So these are the six rules, which if you follow while you are negotiating, it will lead you in getting a positive result. My company, Develop and Grow, keeps conducting web-based as well as face-to-face learning sessions around negotiation skills. If you would like to learn more about the skill, you can connect on the contact details which are shared on the screen. Like this video, share it with all your contacts. Mention whatever you learned from this, or maybe the questions or queries that you have in the comments section. Subscribe to this channel and turn on all the notifications to keep receiving updates about new videos. So, till the next video, Namaste.